Hey y'all, I'm gonna do a CDL switch poor boy budget today, and I've seen a couple videos, so I'm gonna attempt to do it myself. So if you're seeing this video, that means it worked. So, all right, we'll just go in segments and we'll learn as we go. All right, here's my dash. I have a 97 LX450, and on the videos, the first thing you need to do is take these screws out here and here, and take this out, and there's a screw there and a screw there. So I'm gonna pause it and take those out. All right, I got those four screws out, and so be patient. I'm using one hand. So what I'm gonna do, most people take this out and either put it down here or something. I'm gonna actually take my switch and try to hang these wires out because I don't have a switch and I gotta get some front driveline repair, and I need to drive it in two-wheel drive, and that's it. So we're going to try to pull this out and see without breaking this thing. Here, I'm going to use both my hands. Hold on. Alright, what I did was I put a little screwdriver in here and I applied really gently right here, and it popped right there. So having trouble with my steering wheel in the way. Alright, I'm gonna pull this out again, one-handed here. There we go. Pull this back. Pause it again. I need two hands. Alright, on my application, it seems like these wires are very short here from the security, and that's what's giving me the trouble. Alright, as the videos are true, I've seen before, there's a pin thing back here. I'll put my camera's not really all that great. I kind of got to pull that out. Alright. Alright, I got figured out here. Alright, so most people cut that piece out late and pull it out. I'm just gonna unclip it right there and pull it out and leave it. And then pull this through. Bend that wire over. And do that. Alright. So, and then someone said something about opening that pin up, putting a hole right there with a knife so that the hazard switch can clip in. So I'm going to do that. Alright, it seems like on my application here, these wires are very snug, and there's foam on them, and I can't see them, and I do not have an alarm. So what I'm going to do is, just for my sanity, I'm going to go ahead and clip these wires, and I have electrical fittings I can put on later. Alright. Ugh, boogered. Alright. So the next thing we need to do is, my camera's not all that, phone's not doing all that great today. So we need to make this at the groove like that. Because, oops, I just dropped my screwdriver. This pin, I mean, the switch here has two grooves, so we're going to do that next. Okay, so I just made a notch back in there. And instead of a knife, I went with a little hacksaw blade and took that out right there. All right. Moving on to the next step. All right, we're just doing a check on the switch, and it clicks in. All right, next step. Okay, I got them little boogers out now. I had to, instead of going in this way from the front, I had to get my hand back in there, get it under there, and twist and pull. There's just no way I would have done it. All right, so I'm going to connect those back to my switch and then put it on the lower piece here. Another thing I had to do is I had to set my e-brake and pull my lever back and move my steering wheel so I could get my hand in here. I'm kind of a big guy, so I can't move very easily. So that's my application. Hope to the Lord that your wires are another inch longer. There you go. Hold on. All right. So I have the wires pulled out so that when my switch comes in, I can just clip it in and snap it in. So I'm going to put the S together. One of the tricks is right in there, there's a piece where this pin clips in. So this just push it in and it should snap right in. Alright. Alright, so here's the CDL. I'm lost for words right now. You know what that is. And then this one's for the hazard. So this actually goes here. Make sure this is up. Okay. And so for now, I'm going to be clipping it to here. Alright. And when I get my switch in, I'll unclip this and clip it back on here. Alright. So I'm going to probably zip tie this so my kids don't push it back. And then I will have to take the dash off again. So I'm going to just probably zip tie that in so we prevent that. And so let's go ahead and check for our ABS and the CDL light. All right, so I had this thing in low, so I'm going to put it in low. Now I'm going to put it in park. All right, we're going to see how this works. All right, so let's see. I'll install it. ABS off. Diff lock on. Currently, I don't have my seatbelt on. My brakes pulled, and I have a P0401 code right now, which is EGR restriction. So that's why my check engine light is on, and my airbags light's on right now. So those are two other problems I gotta fix. But right now, I believe all this works. There we go. I'm gonna turn it off again. There it is. All right, like I said, I'm gonna zip tie these up so my kids don't push them in. And that's it. Looks like we're done. God bless. Have a good day.